is a screw rod. So here, this is the screw rod wherein we have the diameter 32, and then it is stepped down to diameter 20. Again, it is stepped down to 12, and then we have finally we have M10 thread. And this is the cross section. The details of this cross section, what he has given, is at this particular juncture, wherein he has given this hole. So basically, this hole has been given. That is basically because to rotate this screw rod, so that the movable jaw will going to move over the screw rod. So you can see here, it is a square of 20 M20 thread. This is also the same as the square of 20 into 2 mm pitch. So 20 by 2 means it is a 2 mm pitch. So that is the meaning of it. So now, since we need to create this, so I'm going to take this as the reference, and also this is, I'm going to consider this problem by considering from the front view. So this is going to be the top view, and this is going to be the front view. So to do that, now first I will just hide this, then click on tools, go to ordered, then click on base reference planes. You enable the base reference planes. Now we go for sketching, go to home, click on sketch, click on coincident plane as the front plane, then click on project to sketch, click on OK. You click on this line and also on this line. So from here, you take the distance of 250. So go to offset. So take the distance as 250. So from here, you take the distance of 250 and then fit it. Then go to trim corner between this line and this line. Then we have the 10 mm diameter to a length of 22. So from here, you take offset, take the distance as 5 mm because I'm considering from the center. So then take the distance of 22 mm. So from here, you take offset, take the distance as 22. Then from here, you take this and then go to trim corner between this line and this line. So again, from here, you take the diameter as 12 to a depth of 18 mm. So go to offset, take the distance as 6. So from here, you take the distance as 6. Then zoom window, you take this nearer to the screen, then go to offset and take the distance as 18 mm. So go to offset, take the distance as 18, and from here you take that till here, then go to trim corner between this and this, between this and this. Now again, once you get this, from here he says 20, so offset you take 10, and then from here you take this till here, then go to trim corner between this and this, between this and this. Now you go to fit, you'll get this. So from here again, we have the diameter 32. So go to offset, take the distance as 16, and from here you take that distance, and then go to this and select this distance as 40. Then you go to offset, take the distance as 40. Then from here you take the distance, and then go to trim corner, select about this edge and this edge, and from here to here and from here to here. So this is the final cross section. So but here he has given the radius of 3, so we will going to include that also. Fillet, take the radius distance as 3, and from here to here you take a fillet, then go to close sketch, then click on home, click on revolve protrusion, select this sketch, accept it, select this line, and then revolve it through 360 degree. So you will going to get the mark. So this is one thing. Now we need to apply the thread portion. So go to so here you just come down to this, and you have M10 thread. So to do that, go to home, click on thread, click on cylinder, click on OK. So click on cylinder for thread, click on the end of the cylinder from which the threads will be offset. So from here to here, make it is M10. So tilt the entire thing, you need it, you just say finish. So you're going to get the thread. Again, we don't have the thread in this portion, that is in this portion, we don't have thread. But again, we have thread in this portion only to a distance of 170 mm out of this 170 mm. Now we need to create that. So to do that, command is thread. Click on OK. Click on this. Click on the end of the cylinder from which the threads will be offset. So from here, the threads will be offset by 40 mm and take M20 by 2. So you take M20 into 2 and say finish. So only the thread will be appearing only in this particular thread. Till to this much, you will going to get this. Is it square thread? Yes. So since it is a square thread, we have to change this. Now I will just cancel, go to home, click on this, home, click on this thread, and then you delete this. Then go to home, click on all, click on thread, OK, click on the cylinder for thread, click on the end of the cylinder from which the threads will be offset. Now you take TR20 into 2 and then offset distance you give 40 mm and say finish. So this is how you will going to get this. So this is the square of TR into 20 into 2. So this is how you will going to get the thread. Now the next portion is I want to create a hole. So that is, we want to create the hole at a distance of 20 mm. So to do that, command is go to sketch, or you can create a hole itself. You just go to hole, click on coincident plane, on this plane. Here the problem is we have to go to the parallel plane. Just go to this parallel plane, click on this and take the distance as 16 mm with reference to this. You take 16 mm here on the top side, and then to this you want the hole has to be done from the depth of 20 mm. So here click on this. So what is the diameter? The diameter is 10 mm. So to do that, here drill size is 10. Okay, then hole 2, drill size it's okay. Then through all, through next or through all, then the diameter is 10. Okay, click on this. Now you project to sketch. Okay, click on this sketch and say offset, take the distance as 20 mm. And from here you select this on this side and go to whole circle and take this intersection point and then close the sketch and then finish it. So we have got one hole now. So this side. Now we want to take it onto the other side. Again, go to home, click on hole, click on parallel plane, click on this plane now. You take it onto this side. You take 16 mm and click on this. Again, we go to this option and the diameter is 10 through all. You say OK. Again, click on project to sketch. OK. Click on this and take the distance as offset. The distance is 20. So from here, you take this. Then click on whole circle option and take it onto the intersection point of this. Then go to close sketch and click on finish. So this is how it will be able to create the drawing. Now we'll go for here. Once you start rotating, we'll know how the object will going to look. And this is how, this is the actual screw rod, what we will going to get in the part model. So finally, I will just go to this isometric model, and now I want to save. So click on application button, click on information, go to material table and type Fe410W, which is a screw rod, and apply to model. So here we can see screw rod Fe410W. Then again, you go to application button and then come to information, go to file properties, click on summary, click on screw rod. Say okay, and now save this and save this as screw rod. So type screw rod and say save. This is how you are going to